Today, we're exploring the world of Emirati weddings. We'll meet dress designers and henna tattooists, learn about the traditional weddings of the past, attend a mass wedding of the present, and discover firsthand just how much organization it takes to make the big day matter. I know this will sound strange, but traditional Emirati weddings are a bit of a mystery to us men. Oh sure, I know how we get married and all. But once the families have agreed to the match, there really isn't much for us to do. According to our customs, the rest of the preparations are made by the women because most of the wedding events are for them. The division between genders in Emirati culture is still strong. This means there's a lot of wedding preparations men cannot be involved with. So I'm going to ask my colleague Lubna if she could help. Hi Lubna.
Hi Marwan.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
So listen, I really need your help.
Sure, tell me.
Lubna is going to be my eyes and ears where I can't go. There's so much to find out about wedding dresses, henna decorations, invitation cards, and of course, wedding planning. Now we'll figure out who covers what. Lubna has given me the name of one of Dubai's many wedding dressmakers. She's going in for a fitting later this afternoon, but I thought I'd go and ask the owner a few questions before she gets there. Don't be fooled by how simple the premises look. Hamoudi is one of Dubai's most popular wedding dress designers. Lubna tells me he knows all there is to know about Emirati tastes and trends. Hamoudi, I see you here with all the celebrities.
Yes, there's Sabah here. Here you have Ruwaid al-Mahrou'i, Haifa Wahbi, Najwa Karam. So you could say a good selection.
What are the type of dresses that you have here in the store?
We have a variety, of course. We do designs for wedding dresses, Arabic style dresses, you name it.
You do them all right here?
Absolutely. I'll show you myself right now.
What colors are most popular for Emirati wedding dresses?
Well, during the henna night, we often use a lot of green. When it comes to the actual wedding night, we use white or a shade of off-white, as you can see here.
And the groom never gets involved in the design of the dresses himself?
No, never. Traditionally, in the United Arab Emirates, the groom was never involved in the bride's wedding dress. In fact, in our own shop, we have restrictions on where men are allowed to go. When the women come to try on dresses, even our own male staff are asked to leave the room for privacy.
I'm very lucky today.
Yes, today you're very special. You want to try?
Sure, I'd like to give it a try.
Sure.
So what do I do?
Well, first move the needle around.
There's nothing here.
Okay. It's not as easy as it looks, but we got some here.
You bring the needle from under and pull it through upwards, leaving behind one of these pieces. You then push it back down to close off the thread, and then you take it again from below.
Okay, a little help, Hamoudi. I give up. Hamoudi, is this dress complete?
No, this dress is not done yet. The Arabic woman, or the Emirati woman, really likes a dress that's very grand. As you can see, this dress is still a work in progress. There's a lot to be done. Do you see these areas here? We're going to create small suns from crystals and put them here, 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 and here.
Hamoudi, is this Lubna's dress?
I'm sorry, I can't tell you about Lubna's dress.
Well, thank you very much for today. This is the first time I see stuff like this.
My pleasure. Bye-bye.
I never realized how much work goes into making one of these dresses. I got the inside scoop about how wedding dresses are made. Now, I haven't seen Lubna's yet, and it's considered bad luck, so I think I'm going to make a move before she gets here.
Has Marwan left?
Yes, he has.
Great, let's get started. Wow, amazing. It's really beautiful.
So, do you like it?
Yeah. So, this is what an Emirati bride wears.
Exactly. Emirati women like grand things. And they like their dresses to have unique touches.
Traditionally, after the engagement ceremony, the bride and groom did not meet again until after the marriage. In fact, she would go into seclusion and not be seen in public for 40 days before the wedding ceremony.
Modern weddings are much shorter, but still cost much more. Ancient traditions have changed.
I'm going to meet Moza Sheifan from the Museum of Sharjah. She's very knowledgeable about Emirati culture.
So what do you think of our house?
It's charming.
Weddings in the old days were much better than they are now.
Better? Tell me more about them.
You're not married yet?
No, not yet.
Well, I hope you get married the traditional way then.
Hopefully. So what are the differences between a traditional wedding and a modern wedding?
A modern wedding doesn't have dedicated days of celebration before the wedding. Now it's just one party in a hotel and that's it. Before, it'd be at least a week of celebration. Everyone would gather in the bride's house, there'd be music, food, a big event. Now you don't see anything like this. Many of our customs have been lost.
Tell me more about the engagement. What happens here?
Not too much. Once the couple has agreed to get engaged, the men of the families decide on a day and get together and legally bind the couple together. During the engagement party, people eat halwa, a local dessert. They make a huge amount for the party and then send off what's left to all their neighbours so that they know that someone got engaged in the household. Let me pour you some coffee.
Thank you very much. Moza, I heard that there are some odd customs in areas like Ras Al Khaimah. Is it true that they hit the groom there? And why?
Yes, they hit the groom from outside the house until he enters the bridal chambers to consummate the marriage.
And why do they hit him?
It's just their tradition. The friends of the groom surround him on his way to the bride. Sometimes they hit him, sometimes they don't.
And no one gets upset about it?
No, that's just their tradition.
So is it a joke or is it serious?
It's a joke, yes. What do you think of trying on some traditional clothing?
I'm going to go wear the dresses now. I can't wait.
In the old days, Emirati brides were lucky enough to have a wedding celebration in the evening and then another one the following morning. My grandma had it good.
My mom's going to be very happy to see this. This is called the tasa. This is quite heavy. It's such a shame that you can't smell this because it's beautiful. This experience has made me appreciate our tradition so much more. I'm just really glad that now we don't have to hide ourselves before the wedding.
Dances are an important part of traditional wedding ceremony. These men are doing the yola. It's a dance of celebration. Most of my parents' generation would have been married with several children by the time they reached their 30s. In the last 15 or 20 years, though, the price of weddings and a number of social changes have led to a growing number of Emiratis remaining unmarried well into their 30s.
Concerned by this, the late Sheikh Zayed set up the Marriage Fund back in 2001 to help young Emiratis like these get married.
One way they've done this is by organizing mass weddings. There's dozens of grooms getting married here today. I'm shaking their hands. But the traditional male greeting in the UAE is the nose kiss. So what are these big mass weddings all about?
First of all, it has to be an Emirati man marrying an Emirati woman. There are group weddings that are open to all young men from every part of the UAE. But here in Umm Al Gawain, we have group weddings just for Umm Al Gawain residents. The number could be any number, even over 100.
Once the ceremony is over, the feasting begins.
Now these guys are done, but for most Emiratis, after finding the perfect match, the really serious business of organizing a wedding begins. Invitation cards are big business. Even the simplest ones are elaborate. And the fancy ones are works of art.
مرحبا. السلام عليكم. كيف الأحوال؟ يا أهلا وسهلا. أهلا بك تفضل.
شكرا. So tell us what happens over here. So when people get married, they come to you for these invitations. How important is it to do the invitations for weddings?
Of course, the invitation is the first impression about the wedding. Mm-hmm. So when you get a card, you will know immediately how much the wedding is valuable, mm-hmm. and what is the concept of the wedding.
So has the traditional way of sending the invites changed, like today, compared to what it was like before?
Actually, it is changing because most of the weddings, it depends on the bride idea. Mm-hmm. So, for example, one of the cards which we have, they want to go to the old way of sending the card. It's an mm-hmm. old letter okay. inside the cylinder, and inside the cylinder you will get an old invitation on real leather.
Are these all for local weddings, or do you have different nationalities who also use the same cards?
Yeah, actually we have different nationalities, mm-hmm. and each one have a different concept in his mind. Okay. So for example, this one, the bride, she wants something from Shahrazad, you know Shahrazad in Arabic,
yes.
Thousand Nights. Mm-hmm. So this card take the same design, and this is the we can put on your head, for example, to show that this is like a hat or
that
something.
That looks good on you.
Yeah, thank you.
Do you still use calligraphy in your cards as well?
Yes, of course. If you go through most of our designs, you'll see that we are still using the calligraphy, mm-hmm. hand calligraphy actually.
Okay.
Professional people are doing this job, and they are very unique now to find them, but still it's running and we are using them continuously.
So the groom doesn't get involved at all?
Of course, he's involved in the payment. No, actually he will be there most of the time, and he comes usually in the last stage.
The last day?
The last stage, yeah, to make the approval.
This is also Emiratian, Emirati card, and they do it like a Porsche. They use the Venetian style.
Okay.
As you can see, the cards come in dozens of different shapes, styles, and colors. And they often match the overall theme of the wedding.
Wow, it opens up as well. That's beautiful. Well, thank you very much. You guys have been great help. You have some beautiful designs as well. I think I have a good idea of what the card needs to look like. And hopefully we'll be back to print them with you as well.
It was a pleasure for us to meet you in Color Lines. Hope to see you again.
Thank you very much. Thank you. All right.
Thank you for coming.
Bye-bye.
See you later. Bye-bye.
We Emiratis are a very expressive and emotional people. There's probably no other event in a person's life quite as emotional as a wedding.
So it's no surprise when it comes to organizing one, we go all out.
Hey Marwan.
Hey Lubna.
How are you?
I'm good.
So I'm going to go meet Waleed, the wedding planner.
Okay.
And then I'll catch up with you later.
All right, great. Good
cool.
luck.
See ya.
Bye.
Hey Waleed.
Hi.
How are you? So, organizing weddings is such a huge task.
It is, yeah. It is very huge.
Do you do it all by yourself?
It is team. It's almost like a lot of groups, and there will be a carpet designer and florist, and it's a lot.
It's a huge task, I can imagine. Wow, this is very nice.
And security. And
I love these centerpieces.
Yeah, it is Marie Antoinette.
Marie Antoinette?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. The bride must be very girly.
She is, yeah.
So you can have themes for your weddings?
Yeah, that's right. Cleopatra or Marie Antoinette.
Cleopatra.
Yeah, so it's all themes. Now we can follow the decoration according to what they want. So.
When it comes to food, do people still order camel meat?
Before, yeah, they used to have small candles. They order more in a small lamp.
Oh, lamp. Baby lamp. Mm, and, that's delicious.
So it is very nice, yeah, of course, with the rice and all of this stuff.
Well, Walid has a lot of things to do, so I'm going to go and meet his wife, Rina, and she's going to tell me more about the flowers, which I'm really looking forward to because I love flowers.
Flowers in the past were difficult to find, but today they're grown in large numbers in Saudi Arabia. And plane loads of cut flowers are flown in daily from countries like Holland, India, and China.
Rina takes care of the floral arrangements, and I'm pretty sure it's a demanding job. Hi, Rina.
Hi.
How are you? Okay, it looks like the wedding preparations are well underway. I can feel a real buzz here. Are you excited?
Of course. Every day we have this thing and every day is different.
They are real, right?
Of course. Anything that is close to the people, they could touch, we have to make it as fresh. But anything like we can put on the top or like very high arrangement, we do artificial for one reason.
What?
Artificial, we get like big flowers.
Yeah.
So the bigger flowers from far, it will show more. Like these flowers, if you put from far, it would look like, you know, like an ant.
How much do people in weddings usually spend on flowers?
We got orchids and roses. So it all depends on the type of flowers that we use and the budget they want to spend on this wedding.
Well, I would probably spend a lot because I love flowers.
You can see how is the atmosphere. It's very nice.
Okay, well, I'm going to leave you now and I'll see you later.
Thank you so much.
Traditional wedding preparations are more than just flowers and elaborate decorations. The bride and groom actually have a lot of work cut out for them, especially the bride. Luckily, it's a lot of fun. One special night is awaiting. And let me show you.
Henna plays an important role in wedding ceremonies all over the Middle East. In some Arab countries, it is just used on the hair and the skin as a conditioner and a hair dye. But here in the UAE, we have a special event called the Laylat al-Henna.
Hamad, your house is so beautiful.
Thank you. Sheikha and Farah, they are waiting for you for makeup and henna.
Okay, perfect. And men are not allowed, right?
Yes, sure.
Okay, I'll see you later. Although this makeup is usually a little too heavy for me on a regular basis, this is exactly how they do it on an Emirati henna night.
Are you ready to put your leg for henna?
Yes. So tell me, why is henna so valuable?
They are using from long time. 1,300 years before, I can tell you, it started from henna.
Wow, really?
Yeah, this from ayam time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi. They are using the henna, and that's how I think that they are putting, they are making value for henna, and this is part of their wedding,
mm-hmm.
part of life. Without henna, they don't like to go for wedding.
What is it made of? Do you know?
This henna made of actually henna and some medicine.
Uh-huh. What are your some of your favorite designs?
We have some of designs.
Oh, okay.
Some of them they are traditional, and suppose this design, it is mixed with Arabic and Indian design together. Before the bride was doing this much.
Yeah.
After that, little by little, they like to have here, and now they like to have here.
So the bride will usually be the only one to have the henna, or everybody in the wedding will
No,
have
actually,
henna
as I told you, it is that much great for them that everybody is going to party.
I can't wait to show Marwan what he's missing, because this is wonderful. What do you think?
Wow, beautiful.
Thank you.
This is the kosher which I prepared for you.
So, All this gold, what does it mean?
This is our family traditions. And the ladies in UAE, in our country, they like the gold, and especially in Dubai. They like wear the gold in El Henna.
Now I understand that this is the stage after 40 days that the bride has gone through to being pampered and all the changes I've gone through. This is the last stage that she comes to before she meets her friends, right?
That's right, yeah.
Hamad, thank you very much for this experience.
Welcome.
I know what kind of wedding I would choose, but what about you? Of course, the modern way. The old way is for that time, and the modern way is for our times.
Well, I think a wedding should have a mix between traditional and modern. That way it shows our culture, while also showing how far we've come over the years. When I got married, I did it with a bit of both. I would try to balance between the two. People's way of life has changed. Their views on marriage have changed. So personally, I'd try to balance. I'd keep the essential parts of a traditional wedding and then put them right alongside the more modern aspects of weddings.
Marriage is one of the defining moments of most people's lives. How a wedding and the celebrations that accompany it are organized says a great deal about a people and their culture. Our weddings are colorful and emotional events, times of great joy and much feasting. Families unite, new connections are made. It's a time of new directions, a time of renewal, and despite all the changes, a time of tradition too.
You can now watch Emirati online. Just log on to dubaione.ae.